Here we go. Time for Big Game Breakdown. Live odds, sportsbookreview.com, NFL preseason week 3. This game's on NBC tonight. The Falcons take on Miami. But careful now, the game's not in Miami. The game's in Orlando, and we could see another Hall of Fame debacle here. They haven't played a game in this stadium, on this field, since 1997. NFL game, 1997. And they played a soccer game there last night. Dolphins are 2, 43 the total. I don't know why the line was priced like it. Miami had home field advantage to begin with, Teddy.
I honestly don't think that there were certainly bettors that I talked to that didn't know that Miami wasn't the true home team for this ball game. The game being played at a neutral site that is not necessarily conducive to quality football. And let's not forget, we talk about all the goals of the preseason. What's the number one goal for every coach in the preseason? It doesn't matter if you're on a good team, a bad team, anything else you're trying to do. The number one goal is avoid injuries. And playing on this field, definitely something that I'm going to pay a lot of attention to in the hours before kickoff tonight, trying to assess what those field conditions are actually like, because from early reports, there are certainly some questions in that regard.
Right. So even though they lost and were blown out in Dallas, Tannehill played well, and Gase liked what he saw out of his first team offense.
Oh, yeah. I mean, look, Pro Football Focus did a really nice job. They had a great article grading the best player in the NFL at each position last week, which shows, you know, how serious these guys are at grading out personnel. And you know who the number one quarterback in football? Here's a quote. You know, Ryan Tannehill, Miami Dolphins. Tannehill had a near-perfect outing in his first preseason action, scoring a pair of touchdowns, completing a fantastic pass on a corner route, and not earning a single negative-graded play against him versus the Cowboys. Finished 12 of 20 for 162 yards and 2 touchdowns, also had a pair of scrambles and gained 16 yards running out of the backfield. So Tannehill, who was in line for extended playing time this evening, coming off a very good performance against Dallas last week.
So I guess so far it's the same story with the Falcons, where they made some changes, but again, it's the lack of takeaways on defense. Only 23 takeaways last year, and they were dead last in sack percentage at 3.3.
Yeah, and of course, A and B are very closely related. If you're putting pressure on opposing quarterbacks, if you're putting pressure on teams at the line of scrimmage, you're going to get sacks. When you get sacks and you're putting pressure on opposing teams, you're likely to get more than your fair share of takeaways. Atlanta hasn't had a pass rush, as you mentioned, dead last in sack percentage. Just 3.3% of dropbacks were able to get to the opposing quarterback. A quarterback, I should say. Here's a quote from defense coordinator Richard Smith. To do that, to get turnovers, you have to hunt like a dog to get them. You have to be conscious of it. We haven't been able to get that done. And that's been the case for Atlanta so far, as you mentioned. No takeaways here in the preseason is most assuredly a point of emphasis for the Falcons as they take the field tonight.
All right, game number 2, live odds, sportsbookreview.com. Cowboys and the Seahawks on NFL Network. Seahawks.
Paul, let me jump in. Let me just jump in real quick, because I did have one last point about Dolphins and Falcons.
Okay.
These two teams played week 3 of the preseason last year, and it was Miami 13, Atlanta 9. Matt Ryan only threw 7 passes in that game compared to 28 from his backup, T.Y. Yates. Now, I haven't seen any indication that Quinn has a similar game plan this year. And this year, it's Matt Schaub instead of Yates. And this year, Atlanta has a healthy Julio Jones, who they did not have in the preseason last year. But it's definitely worth noting for the purpose of this ball game that the Falcons' week 3 last year was not a true regular season walk.
Hey guys, for the full video, go to sbrpicks.com.
Research before you bet. Be sure to check out SBR Picks for the best game predictions, breakdowns, and much, much more.